All right, good morning.
Morning.
It's good to see everyone. I know it's like 6 degrees or something outside, but thank you for coming anyway. It's warm inside, and the fire of the Holy Spirit will get us the rest of the way. Megan is one of the many who's not feeling well today. I know I've gotten a couple of texts of others not feeling well today. I have myself been earlier in the week not feeling well. There's a lot of illness, and so we need to be mindful of those who aren't with us, because they're probably not here because they don't feel good. Got sniffles and that kind of thing. So anyway, let us not be discouraged, but instead thankful that we're doing well, and lift up everyone else in prayer as we do that later. You'll see in your bulletin there's several announcements. Though January is typically not as busy as the time of year. We've started our regular schedules back up. As you can see, reminder of our winter weather policy is so anything that happens in the evening, whether that's like Wednesday night dinner or Bible studies or the Emmanuel service on Friday nights, if school is canceled, Bedford County, then that event is canceled as well. Even if, as in this case, maybe the roads are okay, but we don't know that. And I'm not in the meteorology business, and I'm not going to try. So if the caring schools are out, we're out. If they go an hour late, that's cool. But if they leave early, that's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if they have to leave early in the afternoon for weather, then we cancel what we're doing as well. I've heard that there might be more weather Monday night. So that would affect, like, the knitting group. Or Tuesday, if they're out of school, that would impact the women's Bible study. So that's just sort of the general rule of thumb. Now, if you really want to get together with some of those people anyway, maybe at your house, please, if it's safe and you want to do that, you can do that every day if you wish. But as far as an organized event at the church, we just assume that it be officially canceled if the schools are out. Yes? Got it? Okay. That's Bedford County. Also, a lot of you travel from other counties. We have a lot of people from Coffee County and from Rutherford County and other areas. So, if it's not safe for you to travel, even if we are okay, don't hurt yourself. Don't risk, you know, yourself, your life because of a church event. Text me or text someone or call someone for whom it's relevant, but let us know. It's not a big deal, staff included. Okay, I don't care if you're on the payroll or not. If it's not safe for you to drive, don't. Right? I don't get the patience. Right. But you'll see, please look at the announcements we have. Chrysalis flight, Ash Wednesday service, one for winter, SPLC, all kinds of upcoming things. Most of that's February, but anyway. The envelope I handed you today is the first of 6 special collections that we do in the United Methodist Church every year. We did it all last year, and over the course of the year, we collected, I don't even have the final totals, but between $2,000 and $3,000 for special offerings and events, particularly for UNCOR after all those hurricanes. This one is called Human Relations Day, and this offering is used entirely by United Methodist Ministries. And this one is used to promote social justice, particularly in areas that are poor or difficult for those who are dealing with things such as addiction, violence, spousal abuse, mental health, sexual abuse, etc. And so there's a little story from the inside that you can read. And then there is more info online if you're interested in learning more. But we did this last year as well. We're going to continue. A lot of churches say we won't collect special offerings because that would take away from our tithe. But last year, our tithing was very strong, and we collected thousands of dollars over the course of the year for special offerings that just got sent away, and we never even benefited from directly. So I don't believe that having more opportunity to give hurts the giver. I think it improves the giving spirit and culture at our church. And last year, you all proved that to be true. Please don't prove me wrong. Okay. These special offerings are not a substitute for our tithes. They are an additional opportunity to be generous, and particularly within the United Methodist Connection. We know that these funds, through these special offerings, are secure, they are well spent, and there is a record of where they go. Also, we still have some Christmas cards remaining to be picked up. I think Ms. Jane has already distributed some of these to y'all if you're here right now. But in case you want a list, you can come look at the list as we go forward. There's another list out there. Oh, by the way, thank you. Do I have any other announcements that I haven't? Yes, Carmen. It's at 8, and that's Fellowship UMC in Murfreesboro. Our Chrysalis service tonight is at 8 o'clock. Any other announcement?
We have a hospitality security meeting on the Friday at 7:30 in the Lee Mansion room.
Oh, okay. Hospitality security meeting Friday at 7:30 here in the Lee Mansion room.
Anyone welcome to join us for beginning to put together policies and procedures.
Thank you. All right, well, this time I encourage you to greet one another in the peace of Christ, the peace of Christ.
Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate.
passing of his mother, that was unexpected. And so we need to lift him up in prayer. What's her name? Sharon's granddaughter.
Meadow,
thank you. Sharon's, it's her great-granddaughter, Sharon's box, great-granddaughter, Meadow, is about a month old and is in very critical condition. The parents cannot even be with her for fear of contamination. She explained the medicine, but you know me. So, very critical, so we need to pray for Meadow. Also, again, pray for those who are ill. There are so many with colds and flus. We pray that it passes over and strengthens us. That's our prayer. And maybe for snow Monday so that they can have an extra day at home to let it die off. Pray for the Chrysalis flight. Chrysalis being part of the Emmaus community, which is that spiritual discipleship development that has been so important for this church, but many others around the world. We have two ladies here, ladies in this one, and that's Leslie Hernandez and Kaylee. Kylie's last name? Kyle. Again, names, if I get everyone's first name, that's pretty good. So pray for them. They are at Fellowship at this church in Murfreesboro on this journey, the spiritual journey. What other prayers would you like to lift up this morning? I'll begin. Barbara.
Oh, Lord, Brother Darren,
and
back to the hospital. And people had skin this week, but we're not sure which day. He's very bad in pneumonia.
I'm our sister's brother Daryl and Patty is dead.
And
I'm our sister is approved.
And
his sister who is starting Betty who is starting healing too. Alright. I didn't mean to fail to mention that he's doing so well. Praise that Bob Beachport is doing really well. He had to go back in the hospital because of an imbalance of medicine. But he was here Thursday, walked in, he's like, I didn't know I was sick. Of course, he had had that heart attack. But he's like, no, I never felt any pain. I was feeling well. And so he's doing quite well. Even though he's in the hospital, it's good. It's mostly for observation. So I would like to praise that Bob is doing well. And continue prayers that he's. Pastor Laura?
We pray for my brother Daniel. He had some complication with his social complications.
Pray for Danielle, Pastor Laura's brother, who had complications from surgery.
Kathy Martin just didn't feel well enough to come to that side.
Lift up Kathy Martin.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Pray for the all the holy infant, Taylor, and the household. I'm doing well. I heard it works.
Praises for Mike Marfuglier, almost fully recovered. Y'all got any back here? I know you do.
Unspoken.
Yeah. I have a lot of those too. All right. Well, let's lift up these prayers and those we have in our hearts and minds before the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for a new day and a new year, new beginnings. We thank you for the progress and the healing that you have shown through your mercy. You are a God who is concerned with all of us, concerned with our society, that we would flourish and have all things. Lord, we don't always know what we ought to have. We admit that to you. In our sin, we often crave that which is not holy. We pray that you would forgive us these sins and that you would lead us to desiring the things of your heart. Lord, we pray that all of these requests we've lifted up would be desires of your heart. Lord, we pray that however we might be mindful and helpful for these individuals that we would be willing to be animated to serve. We pray for the ministries of our church so that as a group we can continue to bring holiness and healing and a message of your salvation to our community, to all those whom we encounter. We pray for those who are in the face of disaster around the world and those who continue to clean up from disaster that the world has forgotten. We pray all these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray long ago, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Could I have a couple of ushers come forward to collect today's offering? Remember, if you're writing a check and you want to designate the money to something in particular, like the paving fund or this special offering or whatever it may be, just list it in the four line. If you need to use cash, then you can use an envelope and write on there. That's how you can designate if you have need to. Otherwise, you can go to the general fund. And again, shortly, as soon as we get the numbers crunched, we will report the results of 2017. But I can tell you it's been very positive. We have all been very faithful, and I just want to praise God for that. Now let us pray for this offering. Father, we pray that however obedient and joyous we are as givers, that you would increase our joyfulness and our obedience. We pray that you would lead us to be excellent stewards. Even if we've been good stewards, we want to be better stewards of your money. We want every dollar to maximize your witness. And we pray that that's true with this offering. We pray that everything we give would reveal your love, your wisdom, and your salvation to those whom we encounter, now and always.
Blessed be your name, the land that is plentiful, for the streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place and I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name.
When we look at the four Gospels, each of them recalls Jesus' life in different perspectives. For example, the Gospel of John is more detailed, saying Jesus' words. In this Gospel, we can see long prayers that Jesus made, and we can learn so much about prayer in this Gospel. However, the Gospel of Mark is focused in Jesus as a worker. Also, Mark tells us Jesus' events briefly, but we know what I think most of you know, that Mark was not one of the 12 disciples. Also, he is well known as John Mark. And later in the New Testament, we learned that Mark was a helper of the apostles Peter and John. It's very interesting, all these details or all this information. Well, furthermore, the scholars say that Mark wrote the Gospel according to the apostles' testimony in this time with Jesus. Therefore, in our scripture today, I would like to emphasize three words, and they are repentance, confessing, and forgiveness. And then these words convey to John's the Baptist ministry. In verse 3, Mark assures his audience that John the Baptist was sent by God, and this is very important. Isaiah prophesied 700 years before about him. We can see this in Isaiah 41 and 3. Comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice of one calling, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make a straight in the desert a highway for our Lord. This is a Messiah prophecy, which means it's related with the Messiah, and it has a double fulfillment, because it talks about the first and second coming of the Lord Jesus. In addition, this prophecy talks about who would be the one who would prepare the way of the Lord. And Mark 1:4 points out to the Baptist. And verse 5 discloses for us the reason of why people was looking for hearing John's preaching. And so John the Baptist appeared to the wilderness, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem went to him, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him in the Jordan River. And I am amazed for this, because this is the work of the God, of the Holy Spirit. This is God's work, because people were gathering for confessing their sins. And sometimes it's very easy to gather people to spend time with friends, with family, and also it's easy to gather people to cheer their favorite football team. And by the way, the playoffs are here. What is your favorite team? Please don't say it aloud. But to gather people looking for God and confess their sins, definitely is the work of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And nowadays, we need the work of the Holy Spirit moving among us and preparing our hearts to confess our sins. And normally, we don't like to do it. Rather, we try to hide it. Similar, like Adam and Eve, did. But if we desire a healthy relationship with God, we must to follow the example of the people who heard John the Baptist preaching in regards to repentance. And this concept is very important in the Bible. Repentance is important because it is the matter how to prepare the way for the Lord and His work in our spirit. And let's see Luke 7, 29, 30. All the people, even the tax collectors, which means the words in the Jewish society, when they heard Jesus' words, acknowledged that God's way was right, because they had been baptized by John. But the Pharisees and the experts in the law rejected God's purposes for themselves, because they had not been baptized by John. When we repent, our hearts are ready to hear God's voice. And we are able to respond in a proper manner to the invitation to God to walk alongside with Him. When we repented, my dear brothers and sisters, then our mind changed. And we are playing on Christ in God's hands. After we confess our sins and repent, then we can experience God's forgiveness. And we are ready to baptize by the Holy Spirit, by Jesus. And this is another point of John the Baptist preaching. John always was humble. He knew that his work would be only to prepare the way of the Messiah. And he always pointed Jesus. Mark 1:7 says, "After me," this is John speaking, "after me comes the one more powerful than I, the straps of whose sandals I'm not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will be baptized you with the Holy Spirit." In other words, John said, Jesus will immerse you in the living God. He's the one who can transform our lives by the power of the Holy Spirit. We know that baptism in water is not for salvation, and neither it cannot change our hearts or the way we act or the way we speak. It's only by the power of the Holy Spirit that we can be transformed into creatures. And all these things are possible through Jesus Christ, only through Jesus Christ. Jesus came to this earth and identified with us. How did he do it? Well, our scripture today says that the Lamb of God was surrendered by sinners. Since that moment, he started to carry our sins. As we know and believe, and I hope, that Jesus had never sinned. So the question is, why was he baptized? Why? He did it because he wanted to identify himself with us. Let's read 1 Peter 2:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we may die to sins and live for forgiveness. Therefore, his baptism shows us his identification with us. But also, it shows us two important things. Jesus was 100% human, but also Jesus was and is 100% God. Besides, in Jesus' baptism, we see the presence of the Trinity, as it was in the beginning of the creation. We can see the Son of God getting into the waters. We can see the Holy Spirit descending to Jesus in form of the dove, and we see God's affirmation to His Son. The reason that we have faith in this event is solely by the grace of God. If we believe in these truths, then we have arrived to the point of repentance and confessing. And the result of this is the forgiveness of God to all of us. And this is the message of the gospel. The good news for everyone. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to start and continue through this 2018 year walking alongside Jesus. And be aware that when we repent and confess, then we receive the forgiveness of God. There is nothing more important in this world than being right before God through His Son, Jesus Christ. And perhaps some of us this year will pass through some difficulties. Others already passing through them. But remember that nothing cannot separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. May God bless His word.
As Pastor Laura has just encouraged us to do, we are called to continuously renew our dedication to the Lord, remembering our baptism, remembering who we are in Christ Jesus. Especially, it is prudent to do this at the start of new beginnings, such as New Year's. So what we're going to do is something called baptismal renewal, which is a reminder of that baptism that we each carry with us. The same baptism into which Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist long ago, as told in the Gospel of Mark. What we're doing is not baptism. It is just remembrance of baptism. It is not the same thing. And we did this one or two times before, but if you weren't here, then this might be new. So, anyway, through the sacrament of baptism, we are all initiated into Christ's holy church and incorporated into God's almighty acts of salvation, given new birth through water and the Spirit. All of this is God's gift given at no price. It is freely given to those who accept. Through the reaffirmation of our faith, we renew the covenant which was declared at our baptism, acknowledging what God is doing for us and reaffirming our commitment to Christ's holy church. And I want to ask all of you on behalf of the whole church. So when I say the question, you just say, I do or I don't. Do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, oppression, and justice in all forms that they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, putting your whole grace and trust in Him, promising to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all kinds? According to the grace given to you, will you remain faithful members of Christ's holy church and serve as His representatives in the world? All right, let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. And after the flood, you set in the clouds. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you had promised them. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus Christ, nurtured in the water of the womb. He was baptized by John the Baptist and anointed in your Spirit. He called his disciples to share the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here, and by this gift of water, to call to our remembrance the grace declared to us in our baptism. For you truly have washed away our sins, and you clothe us with righteousness throughout our lives, that dying and rising with Christ, we may share in his final victory. Amen. So I invite you, as you wish, to come forward. We'll start on this side of the room, as if we're taking communion, and to receive this water of remembrance. Just put out the back of your hand, and that's where we'll receive it. So, Mike, would you come up here and do a little demonstration for me, just to make it clear?
Let's stand and sing. Let's do it.
Thank you.
Christ, remembering your baptism, you are called in a special way to spread the love of Jesus in this world. Don't forget that. Amen.
Amen.